West Virginia history is known for the swing of a pick, but it was the swing of a bat that connected Coalfield communities during a time when America was segregated. Baseball was a popular leisure time activity in the coal fields of southern West Virginia. Every little coal town had its own team, and every little boy, black and white, had its dream of becoming a baseball player during the first half of the 20th century. There were coal company leagues, United Mine Worker Leagues, and Negro Leagues. Coal camps and baseball were segregated affairs. Even though blacks and whites had separate teams, they often played each other during exhibition and all-star games. Black players could not make it to the majors during the heyday of Coalfield's ball, since professional baseball remained segregated until Jackie Robinson broke the color barrier in 1947. The miners would often work 40 hours in the mines, and some would end up playing as many as 4 games a week. And if coal companies would deny the black team sponsorship, black businesses would sponsor them, and then they passed the hat to pay for travel, uniforms, and equipment. Some of the West Virginia black coalfield baseball teams included the Raleigh Clippers, the Slab Fork Indians, the New River Giants. West Virginia's black teams were professional to the point that they were only one step below the Negro professional leagues. What baseball played by black players gave the local black community was invaluable. But West Virginia produced extraordinary talent, such legends as Angus Evans, who once played center field for the New York Black Yankees and was a minor player for West Virginia's Raleigh Clippers, and Clint Hawk Thomas earned his nickname the Hawk for his ability to dart across center field and pounce on anything in his vicinity. Baseball in the coal field served as common grounds. Everyone participated, whether by playing baseball on the field, coming to the games, or contributing a little money. The heyday of Coalfield baseball peaked just prior to World War II, for it was these great men who built an industry and never hesitated to give back to their communities. Some call them miners who played baseball. We call them American heroes.